Hi viewers, if you are watching Sudha Biology 13, my channel for the first time, please subscribe it. And if you like it, please share it. Okay? So today I am going to discuss about anabolic pathway. That is, respiration is an anabolic pathway. Okay? The name itself, amphi, means dual in nature. Amphi means dual role. Okay? So amphi means dual. That means it has dual nature, anabolic pathway. Respiration is anabolic pathway. It is dual in nature. That means it is involved in anabolic process as well as it is also involved in catabolic process. So till now, for all the classes, we have been discussed the breakdown of glucose molecule. Okay, by oxidation of glucose molecule in step-by-step reactions, finally it releases the inorganic compounds, carbon dioxide as well as water. So that is complete catabolic pathway where there is oxidation of glucose molecule or breakdown of glucose molecule occurs. So that means it is involved in catabolic pathway, and there are some intermediates which are formed during this pathway are involved in anabolic process. Okay, so we say that respiration is both catabolic as well as anabolic pathway. So together we call it as anabolic pathway, as it has dual nature. It has catabolic pathway as well as it is anabolic pathway. Okay, so now let's see. In the previous classes we have been discussed carbohydrates gets converted into simple sugars. Okay, that is glucose, which is a respiratory substrate, the main respiratory substrate, okay, which undergoes oxidation. Even the other forms of carbohydrates, that is starch, gets converted into sucrose. Sucrose further hydrolyzed to glucose molecule, which undergoes oxidation, okay, and to form glucose 6-phosphate. So this is through glycolytic pathway. Glucose 6-phosphate in turn forms fructose 1,6-bisphosphate, as well as next it forms glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate and dihydroxyacetone phosphate when fructose 1,6-bisphosphate undergoes cleavage, okay, in the presence of aldolase enzyme. So this three carbon compounds which are formed, okay, this glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate, which in turn finally forms pyruvic acid, the end product of glycolysis, which in turn forms acetyl CoA, that is by oxidative decarboxylation, the link reaction which is occurring in the perimitochondrial space. And then further this acetyl CoA enters into the Krebs cycle. Okay, so after Krebs cycle, next final oxidative phosphorylation. So through this is complete glucose oxidation pathway we have been seeing. And next, even the fats, okay, fats which are undergoing oxidation. So the fats gets converted in the presence of enzyme lipase, it converts into fatty acids and glycerol. So fats in the presence of enzyme lipase, it gets broken down into fatty acids and glycerol. So glycerol, even the non-carbohydrate compounds also gets converted into carbohydrate compounds or intermediates of these pathways and enter into the respiratory pathway. That is, we call it as gluconeogenesis. Okay, conversion of non-carbohydrate compounds like fats as well as proteins into carbohydrate compounds or even the intermediate products, that we call it as gluconeogenesis. Okay, so this fatty acids and glycerol which are formed, the glycerol get converted into dihydroxyacetone phosphate and enter into glycolytic pathway. So this it is glycolytic pathway. Glycerol gets converted into dihydroxyacetone phosphate and enter into the pathway. Okay, that is glycolytic pathway. Whereas fatty acids, okay, the fatty acids gets converted into acetyl CoA and enters into Krebs cycle. Okay, so this is how even the fat components also convert into glyceraldehyde 3, dihydroxyacetone phosphate, and then to glyceraldehyde 3 phosphate, and then enter into the glycolytic pathway. And fatty acids also enter into the mitochondria through acetyl CoA and continues through Krebs cycle, and finally it undergoes oxidation, okay, through Krebs cycle. And next, coming to proteins. So proteins in the presence of enzyme proteases. So proteins in the presence of enzyme proteases, they break down into amino acids. Okay. So amino acids again by deamination process, they form mainly pyruvic acid. So proteins in the presence of enzyme proteases, they break down into amino acids. As we know, amino acids are building blocks for proteins. So the amino acids further by deamination process, they convert into mainly pyruvic acid and even into acetyl CoA. Okay, so this again enter into the Krebs cycle pathway and continues its oxidation. So this is a catabolic pathway where we have been seen, and there are some intermediate compounds which are formed here, okay, which are used for the synthesis of some organic compounds. That is why we call this respiration also as anabolic pathway. Okay, that means during the Krebs cycle process, we have seen the succinyl-CoA, okay, succinyl-CoA which is used for the synthesis of chlorophyll. Okay, so succinyl-CoA, which is an intermediate product in Krebs cycle, is used for the synthesis of chlorophyll as well as even the cytochrome pigment. Okay, and next, alpha ketoglutaric acid, which is used for formation of glutamate. Okay, it is used for the formation of amino acid, that is glutamate, which in turn convert into proteins. So which in turn forms proteins. That means it is involved in anabolic pathway. Okay, so whenever the compounds are required, they are withdrawn from the pathway. That is succinyl-CoA can be withdrawn, as well as even alpha ketoglutaric acid can also be withdrawn for the formation of glutamate and then finally proteins. Next, one more intermediate formed from Krebs cycle, that is oxaloacetic acid, which leads to the formation of alkaloids as well as even pyrimidines. Oxaloacetic acid is used for synthesis of some alkaloids as well as even some pyrimidines. Okay, next, the acetyl CoA, okay, which can be withdrawn even for the formation of fatty acids again. Okay, so which is entering the pathway to the Krebs cycle, as well as it can be even withdrawn for the formation of fatty acids when required. Okay, next, it is also involved in the formation of terpenes as well as some gibberellins, that is plant growth hormones. So that is why this is all, it is involved in anabolic process, and all these are intermediates which are formed in Krebs cycle. Okay, as well as even acetyl CoA during oxidative decarboxylation it is formed. So all the intermediates which are formed here are further involved in anabolic process. So respiration, it is not only involved in catabolic process, not only involved in breakdown process to form a simpler compounds, it is also involved in anabolic process for the synthesis of various organic compounds. Okay, that is why we call respiration as an amphibolic pathway. Okay, so this is why we call this respiration as an amphibolic pathway. It has dual nature, that is it has catabolic pathway, that is breakdown pathway, okay, as well as it is involved in anabolic process, that is synthesis process. Okay, so that's all about amphibolic pathway.